We are here with Dr. Donna Friess. Donna has an amazing history. You have met her before. She's been on our show before to talk about other parts of her life. But I especially love bringing back repeat guests to talk about new things. And Donna is here to talk to us about her next and what she's doing now, but in a very specific way. So Donna has a 45 plus year career in education. She has taught thousands of students. She'll tell you about that. What I want us to talk about here today, once we get past that, is what do you do next and how can we all give back in this season of giving? How and where should we all consider giving back? Donna, thank you so much for being on the show.
Oh, I'm delighted to be here with you yet again. I really enjoyed it last time.
I'm so glad. And it's a little different. We're not in studio this time. And it's just the two of us having our little girl chat. But I'm thrilled. It makes it easy for us to bring people on from all over the planet now. And from what I understand, our viewers love it. And I know that you know many of our viewers and they know you. So we're all thrilled to have you back.
I know that there are a lot of Barbaras over there. I think there are 102 in the Barbara Club.
Okay. Well, that actually triggers a thought for a future segment for me. So we'll talk about that another time. Yes. But for now, tell us a little bit about your history. And then I want to talk about the fun stuff you're doing now.
Well, it's a lot of fun stuff, but I want to backtrack a little bit. When it was finally getting ridiculous that I continued to drive 70 miles a day, and it was really costing me money to insist on continuing to teach well past when everyone else was retiring. When I finally did give my notice, my friends couldn't even believe it. There must be something, you know, organically wrong with my health if I would ever give up my teaching. No, it was, I simply got brave enough to finally retire, but I would say to my friends, so is there really life outside of Humanities 102? And they would laugh at me thinking that I was joking. I was not joking. I had scheduled my life perfectly. I raised my three children. My husband was in politics. We had a wonderful, full, big life, which included going to teach my college students every day. And so I wasn't kidding, but they laughed at me anyway. So I did retire. And lo and behold, there's so much fun stuff to do when you are not working 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 hours a week. And I feel like I'm a kid in a really cool candy store where there are barrels of this kind of candy and that kind and candy bars up on the shelf. There's so much fun stuff to do out here. My stuff that I do is mostly volunteer giving back to my community, but there are just so many activities. I got back from Alaska on Sunday a week ago, and I signed up for salmon fishing, and I coho salmon, and now I'm thinking, well, that is area that I haven't explored. So I'm continuing to think of fun things to do. So there's lots out there. I think that we want to talk about my volunteer work, but Lauren, I'll let you ask the question.
Oh, thank you. Well, there, like you said, there are so many directions we could go. And who knows, somebody may reach out to you about coho fishing in the future. And so that would be a very welcome question. But yes, lately I have found myself in a lot of museums in different cities and talking with the docents. And that's how this conversation started, talking with the docents and noting that they are mostly retired and incredibly vital, active, interesting. I wind up spending more time chatting with them than I do actually seeing the museum. And then I learned that you were currently a docent at the mission in San Juan Capistrano. And I would love to know more about that because I think those programs are available to all of us and we may just not know about them. So let's start with that one.
Well, so there was a big sign on the wall of the mission in 2016. And it said, apply to be a docent class, training class is starting. I came home and mentioned that to my husband. And he said, well, you wouldn't want to do that because in giving tours, you'd be repeating yourself. And I, okay. And then I thought about it overnight and I thought, wait a minute. I repeated myself for 45 years teaching my college students. I'm good at repeating myself. So I contacted the mission, and it's Mariella in the volunteer area, Martinez, Mariella. And docent classes start once or twice a year, and there's training. I think it's a three, I had a 3-week training session. And what I was wondering about as I signed up, well, do you need me 20 hours a week? How many hours, what kind of commitment am I making? And it was not a big commitment at all. I end up doing about 2 tours a week, but I think it's a 5 or 10 hour a year commitment. It's not a huge commitment, but you get hooked by it because it is so inspiring to work with the guests. We see 50,000 fourth graders every year, and they are so cute and they know so much that you want to do more than that. You want to interact with them more often than that. And we have adult groups come through. We have couples coming through. It's a very vibrant mission. It's one of the most dramatically intact missions of the California missions. And some missions you would go in the front gate and they'd say, this in over here is where the granary used to be, or this is where the tannery used to be. But in Mission San Juan Capistrano, you actually you can walk down into the wine vat and you could see the tanning bins. And of course, we have the oldest building in California in our Sarah Chapel. It's just inspiring. I love it.
I get that from you. And so what I love also is that we never want to stop learning. And the fact that there is education around these docent programs, learning specifically about these locations that you, you might have interest in.
In California history, we have learned it to really get our arms around California history. And so then you become interested in all the eras. California now has a teaching standard for fourth graders that emphasizes the life and culture of the indigenous people. And so we get to talk a lot about that, about the food and the grinding of the corn and their way of life. And there's a big movement to celebrate the indigenous people. And it piques your interest in a new way. I went a few weeks ago to have my hair done. As I got out of the car, I heard all these drumming nearby, and I had to get going to my appointment. I didn't know what it was. It was in the Art Town Park. And I thought, I hope it's there, whatever it is, when I get back. Well, it was a powwow. The indigenous people had gathered from all over the state, and some even from Nevada, and they were having singing and dancing, and a beautiful powwow dressed out. And I'm not sure if before I became a docent, I would have been just so mesmerized by that. So it opens us up to a lot of things that maybe we didn't know about before. So
I like that. Sure, I'm sure that's true. And I remember even going to the Pageant of the Masters and talking to the docents there. And the same thing, everyone who volunteers in whatever format it may be, it's something that's personally interesting to them, but deepens that level of interest. And I also know, and it's not true for everyone, right? We all look for ways to give back. And a lot of times you can, but you prefer not to give money, or maybe you can't give money, but money isn't always the only way to give back. I think giving your time, especially in this way, you spend all this time with fourth graders, and that obviously lights you up.
It does.
And other people will feel better spending time with the seniors and actually taking them on the tours. But I'm sure it doesn't matter who you're talking to if you're sharing information that you love.
Well, and the seniors, they're interested, and they're interested in a different way. And then just families come through all the time too. It's wonderful. And tour groups come through. I don't know if you remember, before I became a docent for 9 years, I volunteered as a loss of a loved one group leader. And that was mostly with working with senior people. But there are a lot of niches and a lot of ways to give back in the community that you know we might not have thought about. So
absolutely, whether it's museums, whether it's the missions, so many nonprofits, so many schools are probably looking for you. Could come in and share about being an author, about being a teacher, about, there's so many things.
Well, and I know that the Boys and Girls Club in Capistrano Valley, we have three sites now all up and down Capistrano Valley, and we serve hundreds and hundreds of children. There are places to volunteer there, helping the students to read and special projects, and there's so much opportunity, really. We no longer have to worry about being retired.
Yeah. And I think that's the point, is that retirement is simply an opportunity to go out and give back in a different way.
Right. Or you could say, this is my docent hat, maybe to try on hats that we haven't tried on before. I don't have my full uniform on here because I wasn't sure how great the hat would look. But
I see your name tag. I see.
Oh, yeah. Oh, and I've got my black slacks and my white blouse and my red. We're red, black, and white.
Oh, okay.
And that's kind of fun, too. There's another aspect of it we haven't talked about. There are corporate events. There are different groups that can rent out the mission in the evening, and then we're specially trained for the corporate events. But a lot of times there's mariachi music, and it's very fun. And then you've got all these dressed up business people walking through. And I remember taking a group along since COVID last year. And I said, and the mission was built in 1776. And the lady said, what's a mission? It's so broadening to realize the whole world isn't immersed in. And so I got to explain the whole mission era and the Spaniards and all. So that was a lot of fun.
That's amazing. That's amazing. Yeah. And I do encourage our viewers to go to the website. It doesn't have to be the mission at San Juan Capistrano. It could be anywhere, but we're going to give you the link to the volunteer programs at the mission at San Juan Capistrano. But you may want to look into other museums, other missions, other opportunities, Boys and Girls Club. This whole show is about promoting nonprofits and doing good, especially in the season of giving that we're in, and looking for ways to not only give back, but be lit up and excited like Donna always is.
Always. Well, and I've made new friends. You know, we docents got together at the end. This, when summer comes, the student tours, of course, stop. And so we had, it's social. We have luncheons. We care about each other. We meet, you know, we meet off of campus. And that's nice, too.
That I just think everything about the program, everything about the way you've approached it, it not only makes sense, it just feels good. And I think it encourages people who maybe haven't thought about what do I want to do next to.
Or what can I do? We want you. We don't have enough docents. We want you to sign up and come be with us. We do.
Well, thank you. That is a very important message, I think, for everyone to hear. I know organizations are desperately in need and do want and need volunteers. So yeah, just something to think about. Donna, thank you so much for coming and sharing with us. I really appreciate it.
Great to see you again. I like your new format. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. We'll talk again soon.